find yourself here on the mat for day 5. And for those who haven't done days 1 to 4 yet, please go back and have a look. They do cover self-love, we look at action, perseverance, finding new ways to achieve our goals, and then finally, on day 5, we're going to do a funky Friday finisher. So what that's going to do is it's going to be a total full body workout. We're going to take bits and pieces from the last 4 days. So we're going to cover some core, some arms, some legs, as well as twists and dips as well. And we're going to throw in one or two inversions just to finish off. And I really hope you guys have enjoyed this program. And I will be doing other ones in the future, some for more beginner levels as well as some more advanced. I'm also going to do some killer abs workouts as well, for those that prefer the shorter and more core-based workouts as well. So let's do the final finisher. Let's start in child's pose and let's do this. And for some of the inversions, they're not overly difficult, but if you're not used to the inversions, please be very careful or wait until you have someone else doing it with you to try them. Like I said, we're not going to do anything too hectic, but we are going to just try and finish off on something a little bit more difficult for those as well, just to really push yourself for that Friday finisher. Okay, into child's pose. Open your knees slightly if that feels good too, sinking in between your legs. Then we're going to bring both of our hands towards the left side. We're just going to drop our hips towards the right. Just get that length in the side of the body. Come back to center. Bring your hands towards the right and then drop those hips towards the left. Heels, if that feels good. And then you can reverse the direction. Crunches. So extend your left arm, right leg, hold it here, engage the core, and we're going to crunch in and extend. Do this for 10, core should be used to this now. Halfway. Really extend that arm and leg out in front and behind you.
Back toe,
kick back up. This time we're just towards your thighs. And we're going to go push up into down facing dog. Come back down into this bear, altered bear stance. Push back up. So don't touch your knees down to the floor. They want to hover. down onto your forearms if this feels comfortable. Like I said, you can slightly rock if it feels good for you in the hip, or don't if it doesn't. Straight back as you're doing this, and then dip towards the floor as you feel it in your obliques. Foot at a time, and just try and find that balance first, just rocking back and forth, And then you're going to lift both up, look in front of you, and hold. And use your arms, your triceps, as a shelf to be leaning on. And you want to come slightly forward. And for those that are comfortable, jump back and come through your chaturanga, or step down and just step back into your downward facing dog. And we'll meet you there.
Child's pose. If you also don't finishing with very soon, and then you can continue with us on the rest of the workout. Behind you, drop the other leg, come back into plow position, interlace your fingers if you're on your hands if you feel comfortable. And for those that are flexible, you can drop your knees towards your ears. Your toes, if it feels good, take
so much for joining me on this 5-day body empowerment program. I really hope you found it beneficial. I hope you feel body empowered. And I really, really hope that you have found some tools and techniques in order to help push through some of those difficult plateau times to really achieve all your goals and your dreams. And I hope that either you've just started this wellness journey and this has really inspired you to continue and to come back and join me next week or on Sunday for a silent session. And if you are more advanced, I hope you've also found that this was advanced enough that you can get a good workout out of it in a very short amount of time. Like I said to you before, I am going to be doing some more beginner-based work as well as some more advanced practices.